Hi, I'm Dr. Todd Cooperman, president and founder of ConsumerLab.com, and I'm here to talk today about B vitamins. Now, ConsumerLab has been testing vitamins and supplements, all kinds of herbal supplements and healthy foods since 1999. We've tested over 5,000 products. So our most recent report, though, focuses on the B vitamins. Now, the B vitamins are one of the most popular supplements out there. They include many different types of B vitamins, including thiamine, niacin, riboflavin, pantothenic acid, B6, B12, biotin. Most of these are sold as individual B vitamins and also as B complexes. Now, there are upper limits you should be aware of when you're taking a B vitamin, and those particularly affect B6, folate, and niacin. Where you can get too much and start having adverse effects from taking B vitamins. So just one point of caution when you're looking for a vitamin, first know how much you should get and know what these upper limits are. You can find them out for free on our website at consumerlab.com/RDAs. And there you can look up your requirement by age and gender for any vitamin or mineral. I'm going to talk a little bit about just some of the B vitamins. There's extensive information in our report that we've just published, and you'll also find there are test results, and several of these products did have more than they claimed, one of which was actually above the upper limit, the upper tolerable intake level, so you do need to be careful when you're selecting a B vitamin. It's best to look for a B vitamin that doesn't exceed 100% of the daily value for that B vitamin if you aren't deficient. If you are deficient, you know, there are certainly situations where you want to get a higher amount. Also be aware that these daily values have decreased in recent years, most notably for biotin, where the requirement had been 300 micrograms per day. Now it's just 30. And it has fallen a bit for some of the other B vitamins. So again, look at our free table to get that information. So kind of going backwards here, I'll start with B12, because B12 is particularly important, particularly popular, particularly for older people. Older people, about 30% of them, have trouble absorbing B12 as they get older and may not get enough. And about half of them may actually become deficient in B12. You only need a very small amount, 2.4 micrograms, which you can get from your food unless you're not absorbing it well. And also some people who are taking drugs that lower the acid in their stomach can also have trouble absorbing some of these B vitamins. Also may need to consider a B complex or individual B vitamins. B12 is also important to older people because it's been found that people who are low in B12 may have cognitive impairment. And by bringing those levels up, you may help that. In fact, if you're getting sufficient omega-3s from fish oil, or even better, from fish, really, they kind of work together. So make sure you're eating some fish or getting some fish oil. Again, preferably getting it from fish that's not too high in mercury. You can see our report on canned tunas and canned salmon, where we reported on the amounts of mercury in some of these products. But B12... you can get from a supplement. You'll typically get a huge amount, though, from these B12 supplements. You'll get just what you need from a B complex, typically, just the 2.4 micrograms. Here you're getting, say, 1,000 micrograms. There is no upper tolerable intake limit for B12, as there is for some of the other B vitamins, but some people can develop rosacea or acne from taking too much vitamin B12. Niacin, this is a form called niacinamide in this particular product. Niacin is also, you know, critical, but you can get too much niacin as well. It can cause liver injury. Most people don't need to take niacin. People had been taking very high doses of nicotinic acid, one form of niacin, in order to lower cholesterol, and it can lower cholesterol, but it can cause a number of other adverse effects. So you need to be careful. I would only take a high dose niacin under a doctor's supervision. Folate is critical during the development of a baby in utero. It helps prevent neural tube defects. If a woman is pregnant, she should be getting folate from a supplement, such as the synthetic form of folate, which is folic acid, or methylfolate. And some people who have a genetic difference in terms of how they handle folate in their body, methylfolate can help them. Most people don't have that issue and really don't need to take methylfolate, and they can just take folic acid. Be aware, however, with folic acid, that many of the bottles have been labeled as saying containing 400 micrograms of folic acid and 100% of the daily value. However, that's incorrect. It's been learned that since folic acid, the synthetic form, is so well absorbed, as is methylfolate, you're actually getting more than you'd be getting if you were getting folate from food. So that 400 micrograms of folic acid is more like 667 micrograms of folate. And since there is an upper limit for folate of 1,000 micrograms of folate, be careful with the folate. With the folate, you don't want to be getting more than 1,000 micrograms. Typically, if you're not pregnant, 400 micrograms of just folate or DFEs, which is like 200 to 300 micrograms of folic acid. If you are pregnant, you want to get about 600 micrograms of folate or 400 micrograms of folic acid. Biotin is another B vitamin. Most people are not deficient in biotin. However, people have been taking it for hair and nails. So you have these different formulas out here. You really need very little biotin. As I mentioned, the daily requirement has actually fallen tenfold. But a study a long time ago did show that 2,500 micrograms taken twice daily seemed to help nails become less brittle, less chance of breaking. Again, it was just one study, hasn't been replicated, yet it's led to a lot of excitement about biotin. Also, if you are deficient in biotin, it can cause hair loss. Again, most people are not deficient in biotin, but again, that's what's created the excitement about biotin and these hair and nail formulas. If you're looking at a B complex, like these B complexes, again, just be aware that some of them are kind of super B complexes. They have way more B vitamins than you need, you know, unless you're known to be deficient. Otherwise, I'd go with one that has more like 100% of the daily value. And you really should look on our website at the free information that'll show you what the daily values currently are, because again, they have changed. Labels don't have to reflect these changes until the beginning of 2020, or if it's a small company, 2021, January of 2021. So look at the information at ConsumerLab.com/RDAs if you want to know what your requirements are and what the upper limits are by gender and age. As well as for all the other vitamins and minerals. Let's see, anything else I wanted to talk about? Just be aware that, you know, some people really do need to take B vitamins. They can benefit, but there are these upper limits. You need to be aware of them. I recommend that you, if you're a Consumer Lab subscriber, read our report. It has extensive information about the B vitamins and all the different forms of B vitamins. Whether it's important to pay extra for those forms or not, you'll also learn in the report, as well as which products passed our tests, which failed, and which are our top choices. So if you have any comments or questions, feel free to post them at the bottom of the YouTube video, and we'll try to respond to them. Thanks very much.